is on the men, and we're expecting top-class table tennis today when the national trials is done. The likes of Ojona Lakpo will be around, Kazim Makonjola. Remember, Sheun Ajetumobi has been away for a while. He's coming back. There's Ahmed Hafiz. I also like to see the new guys on the blog that are doing big things, Azan Nuruddin and Olasukomi Ogene. If we can ever have Ahmed Bello play some good table tennis, it would be nice. I also hear that some of the old guys are also coming to prove that they can play Monday. Moturo has played table tennis for like forever. Michel Guturiola, but they believe they can still beat some of the guys to go to the All Africa Games.
And that is why I'm talking about the competitiveness that the Nigerian Table Tennis Federation has brought to the sport. I mean, we've never had it this good. Yes, you know you can play table tennis. It's not as if there are some people that you of course they are chosen, they are anointed that no matter what happens, you're going to go for a competition. But this time around, you have to fight for a place. You have to make sure that you win the best. For you to win the best, and that makes sure that means you are going to be the best. So for me, I think this is a good one. As I said earlier, but the best man and woman represent Nigeria at the All African Games.
Okay, so that's the part we can play, guys. Are playing at the national trials today. Up your game, give your best chance, and then see if you can feature for Team Nigeria table tennis event at the All Africa Games in Congo in September. Let's go on a quick break now. We'll come back. He's just 29 years old. He ruled the world of tennis at some point, but now a lot of people are saying he's going down. Can Rafael Nadal make a comeback to win the Hamburg Open? The last time he won it was in 2008. We'll talk about it when I return. Stay. So Rafael Nadal making a return to the Hamburg Open after, now listen to this, a 7-year ascent, and I'm defeating compatriot Fernando Verdasco. Now, everyone saying Rafael Nadal's got some power.
He's got some power. You should understand, he had a very long injury, was out for almost a year, and is coming back. Of course, he's had a very bad year to his standard. He's out of the top 10. But then he had to go back to this competition. And it's actually a clay court event in Hamburg.
Played Fernando Verdasco. These days with Nadal, it doesn't mean if he's clay.
But then he had to go back to his strength to try as much as possible to get himself. I mean, and it was a difficult game for him. Actually lost the first set 3-6. And of course, won the other two sets. Just and cool. You could see how difficult it was. Fernando Verdasco, anytime, any day, is a good competitor when it comes to tennis. But then let's see whether this will rejuvenate Rafael Nadal's career.
That's it. So, Rafael Nadal, all the best also. Let's talk about the politics going on in FIFA now. Everyone, hands folded, looking at the TV screens, following what's going on online. Everyone wants to hear the decision of Michel Platini. Is that the next FIFA president?
Well, it's left to be said that Michel Platini has been one of the favorites to, you know, take over from Sepp Blatter for a while right now. And of course, he has criticized the world governing body under his so-called somebody that he was looking up to mentor at a point because of the corruption allegation. And you know, people are. Funny thing is that about four confederations, international confederations, have, you know, given him the support to
CONMEBOL, CONCACAF,
exactly.
Asia, but Africa, so we're still watching.
Yeah, Africa is still watching. Of course, there's a certain Liberian, every president that wants to be the FIFA president. Let's just see how that pans out. But then if Michel Platini eventually announcing as we are hoping is going to, and as we expect that it's going to, is really going to be a very tough one because you've got people there. But then the critics of Platini are saying that, okay, fine, you've been criticizing FIFA on that Blatter, but then you supported Qatar's 2022 bid. So for me, he actually voted for Qatar too. And that is one thing some of his critics would say. And that's one thing that probably some of his opponents would use in their campaign when the election holds in February 2016.
Michel Platini was elected UEFA's president for the third term unopposed and has been tipped as favorite to replace Sepp Blatter as president of FIFA. We will be watching. We'll let you know all that is going down as regards politics coming from FIFA. Let's quickly talk about some transfer football news now. Everyone talking about Arturo Vidal's move to Juve. It's a fantastic signing. I think he's a good player. but might need time to blend in Germany.
Yeah, definitely. Well, is it time to blend in Germany? Come on, he played for Bayern Leverkusen, really did well for Bayern Leverkusen before he went to Juventus. You know, but in Bayern Munich, the
2011, 2015,
well, for me,
a lot has happened.
But for me, blending in Germany, he would blend. But then the question is, will he be able to compete in Bayern Munich? I mean, Bayern Munich has had a whole lot of players. He's supposed to be taking over the role of Bastian Schweinsteiger.
Very huge task.
But Bastian Schweinsteiger, even in his last two seasons with Bayern Munich, under Pep Guardiola, wasn't really somebody you would call a starter. I mean, you've got a whole lot of players in that middle of the pack that can be able to do that as well. So let's just see how it happens. But the question I want to ask is, how would this affect Juventus? Juventus have let Tevez go. They have let Pirlo go. They've let
Arturo Vidal.
And of course, we're hearing that somebody like Fernando Llorente might also leave as well. So that means that Juventus, and they are not even getting players to fill in the gap. So let's just see how it goes.
Arturo Vidal, 28 years old, as you can see, scored 35 goals for Juve, and then his transfer fee suggested around 26 million pounds. Massive for Arturo Vidal. The Chilean actually led his team to win the Copa America.
Exactly.
And then still on fire. Yes, I would say 28, but he's got a lot of power.
Yes.
Good work rates from Arturo Vidal.
Yeah.
And then
that's somebody who would like to have in your midfield.
Okay. Mm. Okay, just to wrap up the transfer and news stories. Also, Arsenal fans, Abu Dhabi will no more be in England. He's not signing for West Brom. He's going to Marseille.
Yeah, I think he needs to start in another league. Marseille, good one for him. And we hope that, very fantastic player, but we hope that he will be able to play football injury-free.
Mm. 29 years old, Abu Dhabi made 125 appearances for Arsenal, scored just 14 goals. But because of injury
really killed him. Yeah.
Cosmos, I must say thanks so much for coming on the program.
You're welcome.
That's it. That's where the curtain falls on this edition of Sports This Morning on Channels TV. But I keep telling you, remember, you can keep talking to us on Twitter, we're Channels_Sports, and on Facebook, we're Channels-Sports. On behalf of the ever-winning sports team at Channels Television Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria, my name is Austin Okunapan. In everything you do, remember, keep talking sports. Bye for now.